In 1963, I went to Ionics Incorporated, and they were the big producers of electrodialysis equipment. But I think one of the most interesting things that I learned about at Ionics, and this was a little study that I had done, and I was looking at the cost of desalination. Now, we've produced a variety of cost models at Reclamation, and we've had contractors do working on this for us. And we always get the criticism that the numbers aren't accurate enough. Well, my response to that is rubbish. And this came from this study that I did while I was at Ionics. So I got some data, and as an employee, I found out two very interesting things. The first is, since water to be treated is highly variable, you've got to have a common factor in this water. And what I discovered was that of all the plants that they had built, the critical issue was the number of electrodialysis stacks of a standard size. And I found out that the factory cost, i.e. the cost to the company of building this plant, correlated very closely with the number of stacks. Now, the second thing was, I looked at the offering price, the bids that that Ionics made for various competitions, and that didn't correlate at all with the factory cost. In fact, if one made a ratio of the bid cost to the factory cost, this varied over a ratio of about 4 at the highest to 0.8 at the lowest. And when somebody tells me that they can estimate the cost of a desal plant to within 5 or 10%, my response is rubbish. Until you have a bid in hand, you really don't know what that plant is going to cost.